Hello everyone, welcome to this new video. In it, I will show you how to embed the report server's report designer in an application using Angular. The report server is a powerful application that allows you to store, manage, and deliver reports for your users. Embedding the report server in your application provides seamless access to your reports without having to switch to a different application. You need two items to embed the designer, as it is not possible to integrate the designer simply with the frame. Report Server's Reporting Service. This service is used to interact from your application. Bold Reports Reporting Tools. Use the JavaScript Report Designer from the Bold Reporting Tools. The Report Server's Designer also builds using the same service. For prerequisites, make sure that your development environment has Node.js version 8 and above. NPM version 3 and above. Let's start by creating an Angular application. First, I need to install the Angular CLI globally. So, I run the npm install command in the command prompt. The Angular CLI is nothing but a command line interface tool that allows you to initialize, develop, scaffold, and maintain Angular applications directly from a command shell. Second, I create the Angular application by running the ng-new command. I name it Angular Report Server Designer. It prompts us for the features to include in the initial app project. I type Y and press Enter to add the Angular routing. I select CSS and press Enter so that the Angular CLI installs the required Angular npm packages and other dependencies. Next, I change the directory to the Angular application root folder. Then, I install the Bold Reports Angular library and add Bold Reports slash types in the application. Then, I open the application's root folder in Visual Studio Code. This is my choice of editor for editing the code. Next, I open the tsconfig.app.json file. I register at bold reports slash types and at types in the type roots array. And jQuery and reports.all under the types array. Here, at bold reports slash types provides the TypeScript definition for bold reports. Then, I open the polyfills.js file inside the src folder. And I import the window.jQuery object, which is required to render the report designer control. Here, window refers to the global object in the client side. The report designer control requires window.jQuery to render. Next, I must add the CSS reference. I open the angular.json file and add the web report designer component style scripts bold.reports.all.min.css and bold.reportdesigner.min.css under the styles node of the projects section. Bold.reports.all.min.css includes the CSS properties for the reporting component. And bold.reportdesigner.min.css includes the CSS properties for the report designer control. Angular 10 and higher will throw a warning that says CommonJS or AMD dependencies can cause optimization bailouts. This is due to adding the scripts in the app.module.ts file, because they use the AMD module loader. To remove the warning, I copy the scripts from the documentation and add them within the allowed CommonJS dependency section. The allowed CommonJS dependency should be added under the options section. And the options section will be available under the projects section. The report designer requires code mirror scripts and styles to allow editing SQL queries and Visual Basic code functions with syntax highlighting. For the code mirror scripts and styles, I install code mirror by executing this command. Then I open the angular.json file. And then add the code mirror.css and showhint.css files under the style section. I copy the necessary scripts from the documentation and add them under the scripts section. I add the report designer component. I open the app.module.ts file and import the @boldreports/angular-reporting-component library. @boldreports/angular-reporting-component provides the UI component for the Angular Report Designer control. I copy the necessary scripts from the documentation and add them in the app.module.ts file. I add the Bold Report Designer module in the imports array. I save the file. Next, I want to add the scripts file. First, I open the index.html file from the src folder. Second, I copy the scripts from the documentation and add them in the head tag. Third, I need to configure the Report Designer template in the Angular application. So I open the app.component.html file and replace it with this code. Bold Report Designer is an element that represents a new Bold Reports Designer control. In this code, ID is a string that specifies the unique name for the Report Designer control. Style indicates the width and height for the Report Designer control. Service URL is the service URL of the report server. Report server URL is the URL of the report server. Service authorization token is the authorization token value retrieved from the server. I save the file. Now, I need to configure the report server's designer in the Angular application. I open the app.component.ts file. I declare the necessary variables and constructor inside the app component class. Inside the constructor, I assign the value for the service URL. This URL specifies the web API service URL. It contains the server name, service name, and the REST API name. The format is http://reportserver-domain/reporting/report-service/api/designer. In this demo, since I have hosted the report server on my local machine, I have specified the report server domain as localhost, along with the port number in which I am hosting it. You can use your own report server domain. Reporting/report-service/api/designer represents the service name of the report server. I enter the report server URL inside the constructor. Here, it specifies the server name and site information. The format is http://reportservername/reporting/api/site/site name. As before, I set the report server name as localhost along with the port number. Site/site1 represents the site from which I am going to load the report in the report designer control. Since I load the designer control from site 1, I specify site/site1. You can specify your own. Finally, I need to add the service authorization token from the report server. For this demo, I am going to use the service authorization token report server UI. You can also generate a service authorization token using credentials and an embed secret key. I have provided the link in the video description for your reference. First, I log into my report server. Next, I open the user profile page. I click the personal access token from the top panel. You can change the token expiration period here. I click the generate token button and confirm it. Once the token is generated, I copy it. Then, I add that service authorization token to the constructor. I save the file. Now everything is ready to load the report designer. In the command prompt, I run this command. It launches the application in the default browser at this URL. You can see the report designer control is loaded in the browser. Here you can add some report items and save the report in the report server. In this demo, I showed you how to embed the report designer from the enterprise report server. You can also embed the report designer from the Cloud Report Server. I have provided the documentation link in the video description. In this video, I have shown you how to create an Angular application, add the scripts to render the report designer control, and initialize the control. There's a link to the documentation with the steps in this video. If you found this video useful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching.